Caution. Danger. Danger.
It used to be the stuff of science fiction, but now they're all around us. Technology has always been a catalyst for change. The invention of the automobile, the internet age, and now another revolution. One that truly could redefine the human experience. This is Generation Robot. Presented by Mouser Electronics, Microchip Technology, Intel, Analog Devices, and Molex, this five-part series will find the companies, humans, and robots that are changing everything. Not in sci-fi blockbusters, but right now in the real world. Places like the Institute for Robotics and Intelligent Machines at Georgia Tech, also known as IRIM. Let's start out with your definition of a robot.
That's a weirdly hard question to answer, because in robotics, we used to think that the robot followed the sense, plan, act paradigm, which means it's something that senses its environment, thinks about what to do, and then changes the environment through action. So in my lab now, a robot is something that you talk to. It's an appliance or a machine that you talk to, and that can make changes in the world.
The things that we use in our everyday society could be a robot based on the classical definition. A lawnmower that goes and mows by itself, is that a robot or not? And so I think that the social interaction is where the target of robot is moving to.
We have an opportunity to use robots to enrich the human experience, and we should totally embrace that.
The system has been calibrated to my face.
That's correct.
It knows where my mouth is.
That's correct.
And I have the interface right here.
Well, let's try to get you to eat some yogurt.
The robots are leaving their cages and they're entering our daily lives. They're showing up in our homes, in our hospitals, on our farm fields. And this is a completely new breed of robots that we're experiencing.
And of all the things I've seen here, this improvising, jazz-playing robot is one of the most impressive.
One of the things about music is that it's about patterns, and there's creativity in how you construct these patterns.
It's really, really interesting that robotics used to be all mechanical engineering. And now, modern robotics involves psychology, because almost all robots we're envisioning are actually going to work together with people. So a modern roboticist needs to understand not only engineering and computing, but also people.
The work that's occurring at IRIM could be considered game-changing, but they're not the only ones. To see some of these robots up close and in person, I'm headed to Germany to learn about how humans and robots are working together to build a new tomorrow.